Hello there and welcome back to my videos. In this video we want to speak about the project authentication project where you want to have a microservice, and in this microservice we having a login information and everything we need, so you know that from all the previous video. And in this video I will speak about the middleware provider and how it's working. And the middleware provider, it's something we want to add, because in the previous video we were adding the providers, and now we will allow only the user get access to the system if it's having the provider ID, the secret key, or it's coming with the public key, or it exists, of course. If you are administrator, we will always allow you to get in, because then you can create a new account, you can add a new provider. But if you're anything else than a system administrator, then you need a provider. That's what we want today, and I'm very happy to have you here today. I hope you want to subscribe this channel in the right corner with below in the thing. And if you have any questions, if you have any feedback, please leave the comments. Remember to like and share this video when you're finished with the watching. So let's begin. The first thing we want to do is adding the new middleware. I will create a new file, because now we get so many middlewares. We will open 4 middlewares right now, and that's why we will create a new file. And let's create, to call it provider verify. And inside the provider verify, we will make a class called provider. And we'll make it here. Then we need the call, and we need nothing more, so I will just move those. And now we can going back for the app file here, and going for the top here, and say from middleware import provider, and then provider. And this middleware we want to add at the last one. We have 2 middlewares here, and it's always the last one that will be the first one will be the last one. I don't know why really, but that's how it's working. Let's add some spacing here so we can see what happened. And then we are ready to continue in the provider file here and type some code. The first thing we will have in working inside here, it will be, we will have the request. It's equal to request, and to get this one we need to importing the from the middleware import request and record response. That's what we need inside for now. And then we will add a login. I know we need to do this here, middleware, and we want to tell it's hitting here, and want to import the login here. And then we need to set the request method. It's equal to request method. And then we need the request path. We need this later, so that's why I'm adding it. And then we need to request verify. Request method here. And why we do this, it's because we are preparing for the provider. And in the provider we will, in the next video, we will add the web login. So if you're coming from the website and logging into this providing system, then we need to know where you are. And if you're in the wrong URL and wrong area, then we can decline the access and say you can't go for this access. That's what we basically do with this, but we will check, because you are administrator and all the users need to be allowed to log in and be verified. So that's why we use that too. So let's continue. Then we need the provider ID. The provider ID will come in from the headers, if we have it. And we will call it provider ID. If it's in request. Yes. Else we want to return request get ID. That, whoops. What we're doing here is we expect, if the provider it's coming from the header, then it's probably a server ID. That's meaning we were sending a REST call. And if it exists, then we will use it. Else we will use the ID from the UL params. And if this is not working, it will defined as none. So that's what we want. Then we need to say provider secret. And then we need the provider secret. And it's again, we only check this if request hit us. If this provider secrets in the request hit us, else we'll return none. We will not check the secret key from the UL, because we don't want the client to sending the secret key. If you have the secret key, you have directly full access to this system. So we will not allow this. And then we need to send the provider in the system. The provider we for now call none. And that's meaning if the provider found and you're allowed to access and everything here, then I will send the provider for the next level, so we can take it in the endpoint. That's what the plan is for this one. So just keep this here. So let's starting to add our if statement. If the request, this one, administrator, it's true, then we just say login. And then we need an else statement. It's normal. Then we have a desire to check what happened here when we are logged in as a normal or an administrator. So let's go back for the postman. Just a couple of minutes, I can show you what happened. And then we probably want to see the error, and that's because you can see the key error administrator. That's because we're not having sent in the middleware inside. So we need a little bit check before we do this. And we just said the request verify, not in those one. And the first one should be account sign in. And this is a get method. And then we need account, and this is a put. That's when you create account and you want to sign in. And then we're going inside here and say else and put this in, and I'll just make a login. I'll log in here. And then we say, account, try to log in, sign in, or create a new account. That's the middleware we want. And let's go back for Postman and press. And then you can see we hit one more because we don't inside the account. And that's not true, we should have it. So let's see how the request here it's going. Whoops. See how it's reacts. I need that. And I found the error as because we need to move this and it's correctly what we're doing. Just move it around here. And now it should work. And something is still not working, so that's perfect. I don't know what happened for me today, but I have everything on the control until this happening. So I'll check it one more time. The error is appear because we need to return error the self app, and we do this to inside here and start response that we're doing and save it again and going and try to sign in. So for now we can sign in again and we have a token, so that we will save to later. And we'll go back for the code here and see what the next thing we want to do before we are continuing. What we will do now is be sure if you're not administrator and the provider do not exist, then we just block the request. So that's what we want now. So if not, request here an administrator and the provider ID is none, then we go inside here, LV, jump inside. First we want to add is a login, say middleware, provider ID not found in headers, header or param, queue params. And then we will say res, response, we'll say x, provider ID not found in headers or ID in query params. That's what we want to explain now. And then we need the meantime and text plain and status 501. And then we need to return res here and say environment and start response, and that's only happening if we are if we're not in the sign in and the account. So if I'm going for sign in again, this one will not appear, it will going directly for this one. So let's taking the token we have from a postman here. Let's sign in again to be sure it's working. It's working. So let's go inside and copy this one. We're going for verify. I'll just paste it in and send it. And we're now verified. It's okay. Just for fun, I'm going for the database and disable my admin rights. So I'm just going to say false here and see what's happening here. It's saying yeah, you need to provide ID, and you can see I have the header here, I have testing file, so that's what working if I'm sending inside. So let's do that part. So now it's a if you don't have a provider, then return here, and the provider is none, it's because we don't check about the provider yet. So let's go back for the Mongo again and see the provider. We have the provider here, and what I'm doing now, I'll just take I'll just take the public key here and add it. Copy the value. And going, no, I need the provider ID and the secret. The value. And then need the secret. And then see what happening now. We account match the query and everything is done. So now we are finished for this one. I'll just minimize this. Then we will have the questions about its account administrator or it's a normal one. And for now we will create the normal one. And that's what we going to do now. So we will take the administrator later. So let's make an if statement here. We'll say if the object ID, it's coming from a provider ID, it's in request. Here we have a list of the account and the providers. All the providers the account is binding up for, it's inside here. So we will just check about what happened. And then we are logging and say middleware. Account match provider ID and allowed to access. Else login info account do not match any provider ID and do not have access. That's what we want to do now. And you can see the object ID here is not correct, so we will go in the top again and say from basin object ID import object ID, and then this should fix the issue we have right here. If the provider doesn't exist, then we just need to cancel our request, and we need the response here, and we will tell the user account did not have access for this provider. That's what we want to say. And we need the meme type, should be text plain. And then we need the status code, should be 403. And then we need the return res. Environment start response. That's what we want to return now. Let's give him a little bit space, I think. Ah, it doesn't matter. I'll go in for the postman again and let's see what happening. I'm still okay, so let's see what happening here. But change the D to the F. I don't have access because the provider doesn't inside this one. So for now that's working pretty well. So now we need to verify about if you are logged in as an administrator. Now we need to do the last thing here in the provider section. I'll just minimize this. Whoops. Because now we have the login for the guest here, so we don't need this one more. So now we need to say if the user has the provider in, then we need to check about the provider exists. For this we need to say the provider, it's equal to provider, and we don't have that, so let's go up and say from ODM provider, we have it here, as ODM provider. I'll just call it that. Go down and then we just say objects get pk. The primary key is the same as provider ID, and then we need to provide a secret. Wrong one. Secret key private. Then we need to provide a secret here. And we only check that about because you're not logging at the web. So let's go for this one. Yeah, that doesn't make any sense what I'm saying right now. Whoops. Provider is equal to, and then we need the name on the provider. Provider name, and then we need the ID on the provider ID. That's what we want. Why it's giving errors? Because we don't have an exception. Yes. Okay, what I'm meaning is we are sending with the header, and the header having the secret key, and that's why we are logged in and see what's happening. Then we gonna to try about the provider ID and the secret. If this match, then we sending the provider ID and the name of the provider for the next level. If not, then it doesn't exist, and then we just quit the access, like you don't have access for this this one. So what we're gonna do up here, it's say from Mongo engine import does not exist. We need it down below here, and we got it here, and we got login information here for the internal use, and provider secret or provider ID did not match in the database. That's what we're gonna check up. And if not do this, we want to sending the response again, and we can just copy this one. We have it put it out here, and we can just copy this one and minimize this one more time. And that's fine. So now if the provider doesn't exist, let's say the secret key is the wrong one, whoops, that's the database. Going for the postman, everything here, it's not running because the application is crashed. So let's running up and say that we have the secret key here and say 5, 4, then we should have didn't have access to the provider. If I replace it back for 6 again, then it should be the correct. It's changed from forbidden to status, okay. So now we basically have validated about if you're not you are administrator and you have the secret key and you have the provider ID, then you can basically be logged in, succeeds for the single provider. And that's perfect, that's what we want to do. So the last thing we need in this video, it's allow the administrator to do the same, just without any kind of access ID. So let's go inside here and say, if the provider ID is not none, then we go inside here, else do something. And if the provider ID doesn't exist, then we will just say forbidden. I think we will take this one. No, when I'm thinking about it, we don't need it, because if your administrator and the provider ID does not exist, then you just take it out, and yeah, that's fine. Because if, yeah, that's okay. Sorry for the confusion. So we will say try the provider is equal to ODM provider objects and get what we want. It's a provider ID if it's set. We don't want to check about the secret key because we are administrator, so we just need the ID of the provider, then we get full access. The administrator, it's only if you are system administrator. It's not if you are a provider admin. I'm not checking that. This requirement is if you're a system administrator. And then we need the provider, and we need the name again. Provider, the name, and then we need the ID of the provider. Got it here. And let's say the ID doesn't exist, we need to send this out. And I'll set the info here. The provider not found in the database. And then we need to response not found. The provider ID, we just copy this one. Let's just copy this one. I'll just change the name here. I'm not found with this provider ID. We are administrators, so that's okay for us to do. Let's go in for the database here in the, and then I'll just turn the I'll just change the administrator for me here. And then I'll send it in. And I'm just the administrator, so let's see what's happening. Got an error because the application doesn't run, so do it again. We are doing it inside here. Let's change the get out the provider here. And should working still, and it's due. Let's see what happening if I change the D for F and it's not working. So it's jumping inside the administrator here, you can see. So it's working as I want to do. So that's it. Now you have the provider check on the administrator level, and it's requiring for the secret key and a right provider ID. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope you enjoy and you learn something from me. And thank you so much for subscribing this channel. If you don't know how you can subscribe, you can of course press the thing below in the right corner, hit the like button and the share button of course, and add this for your playlist. I will recommend you to see the description. Here I have all the links for the you need for this project for the GitHub, and if you want a donation you can do it on the Patreon, so it's up to you. I do this because I'm thinking it's a very fun for me to do, and I really hope you enjoy this video. Thank you so much and hope to see you next time. Bye.